average cruise is 7 days long. The average ship has 3,000 guests. The average guest will produce around 3 kilos of poop. That's 9 tons of poop that have to be dealt with, and that's not including urine or the water needed to flush it all away. Of course, it could all just go into the sea as fish poop does, but apparently dumping human poop into the sea could upset the ocean's natural bacterial balance. This means that 9,000 kilos of poop and over 500,000 liters of wastewater have to be processed on board the cruise ship. Number 1. Down the tubes. It all starts with that first flush. Your waste gets sucked away using a vacuum waste system to reduce the amount of precious water used on each flush. Number 2. Black water system. Your waste enters the black water system. A cruise ship has 2 water systems. The grey water system that deals with cleaner wastewater, like laundry, shower and basin waste, and the black water system that deals with, well, the black stuff. Number 3. Prefilter. The waste travels through the waste pipework down into the bowels of the ship, where it passes through a basic filter that removes the matter that can't be processed on board. This matter is stored until the ship docks, where it is then taken off onto land and processed. Number 4. Aeration Chamber. The waste that made it through the first filter enters an aeration chamber. In this chamber, air is blown in to aerate the wastewater in order to encourage oxygen-hungry aerobic bacteria to begin breaking down the waste matter. Number 5. Settlement chamber. Next, the waste enters the settlement chamber. Here, the waste is left to, yep, you guessed it, settle. In this chamber, the denser water falls to the bottom and is sent back to the aeration chamber to repeat the process. The lighter matter forms a scum layer that floats on top. This layer is slowly broken down by anaerobic bacteria, smaller bacteria that don't require oxygen. The water in the middle area is now relatively clean and can move on to the next chamber. Number 6. Sterilization chamber. In this chamber, the clean water undergoes a sterilization process. Different companies use different methods for sterilization. Chlorine is used sometimes, but it is generally thought that it could be a risk to marine life. The most common method used is UV light. Number 7. Dumping. Now the water is sterilized and clean enough, it can be released into the sea. However, there are various rules and regulations about how fast the ship should be traveling when dumping wastewater and how far away from land it should be. The commonly agreed distance is around 12 nautical miles. We hope you enjoyed this video. Let us know in the comments and please like and subscribe for more.